Well, hello everybody. It is just about 12 hours and 18 minutes into the day of Saturday, June 18th, 2016, and I'm on the road again. I realized as I did some looking around that I needed to go shopping again. Do your inventory once you get back. Assume you've gotten everything, and lo and behold, you haven't. So that means another trip out. I'm going to a different place this time. I'm walking down to the west. Yeah. I still gotta work on my pans there, because I noticed if my pans aren't proper, it's just too quick. So let's try that again, because this is behind the scenes. This is also practice. Try to do a good pan. And a good pan is like that. A smooth type of motion. That's a good pan. And you can sort of see where I'm going. Now pan back. We'll see how that ends up working out. Now that our sound is working good on here, we've got an excellent picture, quality picture. I gotta try to find some way to bring the Nikon image, the one I'm filming on the DSLR, up to the level that Sony has right here. And this isn't an expensive camera. It shoots 1080p, 60 frames a second. That's what I'm filming at right now. And the quality of it, it's just absolutely amazing. The Nikon, I'm not so impressed with it. You know, I thought Nikon would be better, because Nikon is a good brand. I know Nikon, you know, for photography, they have excellent cameras, but their video frame coming out of it is not, the video quality is not so good. Sound is all right, but then again, it's a lot further away from me. I'm not filming close up. So, I don't know whether that's the issue or whatever the issue is. So, and I also sort of resolved this sort of flicker issue. For some reason, the camera goes into this flicker mode, and it picks it up even on the film there. And it doesn't matter whether it's set to 50 or 60 megahertz. You still see the flickering of the image within. Than the camera. So anyways, I'm doing multiple takes now of a variety of different shows, just sort of testing things out and seeing how things go, and we'll see sort of what the quality ends up being as we move along. So we are on a new schedule now. We are doing more filming, so things are pushing ahead, and for me, that's good. You know, because that's what we want to do. You want to have something that moves ahead, something that's, you want to see some form of progress. I have other work on the schedule today to work on. I have to finish some chunk of the web presence now. I'm sort of starting to connect my systems to the internet better. And so now I'm working on my web presence to improve that. I did the bits and pieces over the years. But now I gotta start tying everything together and sort of making it sort of a presentation that's sort of well spread out, that's sort of well representative of the research that's actually going on here. And of course, that's gonna take a bit of doing. It's not gonna be something that's so easy. So, anyways, we're at the end of the street here, as I'm now in Victoria Park. heading south. Let's do this again. Let's do nice. And I have to practice at this. This is something that needs to be done. Pan back. So you don't always realize when you're filming like this now how quick something is. So before I just do a normal, oh yeah, pan, just turn it around, bang, that's it. And then when I'm watching it, it's like, whoa, that moved quickly. And so you realize that you've panned too quickly, and rather than showing a good image, you actually have something that's, you know, not so hot. So doing the panning, practice panning is something that is a must right now. So particularly since I'm walking more like this. Anyways, I think that's going to be it for now. Opening discussion for this episode. So anyways, I will see you maybe a little bit, or because we were walking, I'm doing TEDx. Right now I'm thinking in my mind. If I have something to say, then I'll come back and say it. Well, everybody, welcome back. It's the next segment of Big Bang 3 Hours BTS vlog. It is just about 13 hours and 9 minutes into the day of Saturday, June 18th, 2016. I just finished food shopping. This is a typical North American mall. I didn't go to the Asian mall because some of the food that I wanted isn't there. The TNT has 95% of what I want, but occasionally I have to come here to get things that the Asian store doesn't have. So that's usually once every 2 to 3 months. I'm not gonna make the light, so I'll just wait here. Yeah, it's a pretty busy road. This is Steeles. This is Steeles. Let me just practice the pan here. So that's Steeles. This is where I am right now. I have to go over that bridge. It's not a pretty bad walk. It's a little bit longer than the TNT, but not much longer. And but there's more roads to cross. So, and it's time to cross. It's just about 80 degrees outside. So, impatient people. Every time you hear a horn, usually it's because someone's impatient and wants to get around fast, but they don't really get too far. The speed kind of, particularly in traffic, if there's a large volume of cars on the road, and particularly on Saturday near any shopping mall, that's going to be a case. We're going to be the case. Then you're going to expect to be in traffic, but I usually do. But when I used to drive, or if I'm in the passenger, I have my music with me. I just put my headphones on, start listening to music. Or if I'm in the car, if I was driving, put the radio on, but listen to some music. And that usually took away a lot of the stress of anxiously waiting and figuring out how long it took for someone to figure out what they wanted to do. This is the tricky part here now, because there's two lanes here. One goes up, it's a sort of a split way, fork in the road, and you don't know whether the car is going to go straight ahead down in this direction, or they're going to go off on the left here, because they more often they don't signal, so there's a large volume here. I got to wait till there's a good gap and then cross, so that's going to be the issue here. See, there you go, there the truck went right, the car just went left. So if I had timed it on the truck there, it would have been so good. So I just got to, I have to wait and be patient for a long enough break. Now, cars are supposed to stop and let you go, but more often than not, they don't. So this is the reality. This is the reality when it comes to the right of driving, or that we'll call a privilege, and that basically walking is your right. Not necessarily. And the thing is that they added bike lanes now. They're adding bike lanes to a lot of places. And now they're planning to add walking lanes. Well, why? Because more often than not in the summer, and this is in the winter, these sidewalks here, they're covered in snow. And they don't always plow them. Particularly on the bridges. But the problem isn't that this because it snows, it's because of the plows. The plows don't stop to prevent the spillover from the road when they're clearing the roads. The banks pile up on the sidewalks. And so even if you put bike lanes and whatever lanes you want to put in there on the side of the road for pedestrians and cyclists, in the winter, when the plow comes along, they're not going to be clear. So the bikes, the cyclists and the pedestrians are going to have to walk in the street. And that's kind of the reality of the situation here. Now, they did fix up the guardrails. And I kind of like where they fixed up the guardrails. Before, the guardrails were down low. But here, if we can sort of pan around, back around to myself. You see how they're up to my neck here? There's no way I'm going to fall over. I'm not going to fall off this bridge. But if it's around my hips, if it's down around my hips like this, around that height there, then I will fall over. It basically has to do with physics, the potential to fall, right? It's the potential energy. I have a potential to fall over there. That's the potential. The lower the rail, the higher the potential of my falling over. The higher the rail, particularly above what they call the pivot point or the center of mass for the body, that's basically around the hips, then the less probability that you're going to fall over. You have less potential to fall over. So, that's kind of the way it worked things, and they finally fixed this. But it did take them apart. Oh. This thing was built, I think, in the 70s. This was built, and it's now 2016. So it took them 46 years to fix the bridge. So that kind of gives you an idea of how important pedestrians are. To the United States, over any major highway, all the bridges and walkways are always fenced in, so there's no way you can fall over. But they didn't do that here. It was never a standard here. It was always assumed, well, if people fall over and it becomes a problem, then we'll deal with it. So, that was the attitude in Canada. But again, that's socialism. Socialism, although it talks about helping people and being kind to people and so on and so forth, the reality is socialism is very barbaric. It turns people into animals. And there's no kindness, there's no thought for the other human being unless there's a cause. But if the cause is that this group of people who are not following along, doing the right thing according to the state, these people, or they become useless to the state, these people can now be euthanized. This is what's happening here in Canada. This whole right to suicide thing, the right to die, well, it's turned into a whole euthanasia thing. They've opened the door now where doctors can know if someone's too old and too sick, or this is in the doctor's view, they stop giving them medicine, they stop performing surgeries on them, no life-saving is given to them if there's an emergency, and they're going to let these people die. In some cases, they're going to euthanize them. And this was the whole issue going on right now. And people say, oh, Justin Trudeau took an easier way. He didn't actually go through with what he initially said. But I said, take a look at what his initial speeches were like. And that will give you an idea who Justin Trudeau is. He's just like his father. And his father was a lot like Hugo Chavez. It's about the cause, about this whole thing called social justice. And social justice is simply is rhetoric. It doesn't mean anything to these people. And what they do is they simply rip everybody off. They tax everyone to a degree. They turn everyone into slaves. And then they give to themselves and their crony friends. They set up monopolies and they appoint people to be heads of these particular monopolies that they set up. This is what they've done with Bell Canada. This is what's happened to Rogers Cable. And this is why in Ontario, you have a black hole in technology. We have the highest prices in North America for cell phone and internet access, particularly on a wireless. In other words, we have our systems are fundamentally broken. Why? Because there's no competition. The Bell Canada is now owned by the unions. The Canadian public sector unions are now owns Bell Canada. It owns the TV stations that are connected to it. And basically all the TV stations on Canadian channels, on Canadian TV, even though they look like they're American, they're actually owned by Bell Canada and Rogers. So if you go back and you look at who owns what channels, you'll see that the union owns a good, I would say 60% of the dial, 60% of the channels are owned by the union. So try getting a fair shake on the air there. You know, try going to the CRTC and getting the union people at the CRTC, and that's the Canadian Council for Restricted Thought Control. They're all unions, they're all in this together. So what happens is they're not going to go against people who are part of who they are. And this is why, you know, you wonder why police get away with what they get away with. Very simple, the unions, right? So unless you vote out the unions and these people who support them, this basically means the Democrats, the Green Party, anyone who's on the social left, get rid of them, you get rid of the unions. It's that simple. Anyways, we're coming to our crossing point. And this is our time to turn the camera off because this is a major street to cross at. And I'll see you when I get back to my place. Well, welcome back to the next segment of Big Bang Theory's BTS vlog. Yeah, I'm sitting outside airing out the place. It is 9 minutes, actually, 9 minutes. Yeah, it's just 9 minutes into the day of Sunday, June 19th, 2016, yeah. That's 9 minutes is just into the day. It's a little after midnight. I thought I had enough time vlogged on here, but my sweet little camera told me that it didn't, so I gotta get at least another 5 minutes, if not more, on here. To get a good 20-25 minutes in there into the good 25 minutes in the vlog. So I've got another basically 5 minutes to talk to you guys. Things are coming along. A large chunk of the work that needs to get done is actually getting done. I've actually been kind of surprised with the quality of the lighting here. I thought I'd be worse than what it was, but it's not actually not that bad. I took a look at some of the videos that I've shot out here, and even in the areas where I thought were dark, it actually came out pretty good, so I'm happy with that. Work on the web presence is coming along. I've made significant improvements today to what's actually going to be going up on Sunday and Monday. I was hoping to get things done today, but it didn't work out. How you want to? Part of the problem is when you're sitting down and writing, you got to figure out what you want to say, how you want to say it, what you want people to see, how you want people to see it, how you want them to interact with what you're doing. There's a number of different issues that that kind of have to sort of be taken into consideration when you're. Putting together this type of, you know, you whatever you're presenting, you know, whatever you want people to interact with. And so it does take time. It does, it's not a short and easy thing. So you take your time with it, and bit by bit you get through it. And that's sort of the situation here, is that the weekend work is going to leave me in a very good position for this week, for the week coming. In terms of what I can actually get done. And in other words, I'm looking at a pretty good week this week in terms of what I'm going to try to schedule in. I'm airing my place out. It's got up to about 80, 84 degrees inside. Yeah, but now it's about 70 degrees outside here, so opening the back door allows the pressure to drop. We would sort of, when the heat builds up, the air builds up inside, it doesn't move anywhere, and you have to slowly let the pressure out. And that's what's happening back here, as the pressure, there's a lower pressure, lower temperature outside, pulls the warm air out. The front room air conditioner actually takes that air and cools it off and pushes the cool air towards the back, and produces a breeze from front to back that cools the place off and airs it out. Although it's ironically enough, the way to resolve some of your if you want to do what's called scented candles is if you really want to sort of do it properly, and sort of not really proper, but have a better effect, then you don't have to light them. As long as you've got a good scent out of it, place your scented candles by the heating vents, and whether you have air conditioning on, any airflow that's coming out of it will circulate the scent and sort of bring it all over the house. So I think that's one option to do things. So anyways, I think this is going to be it for now, because we're at the 16-minute mark, so we're still 30. Let it go a little bit longer, and then we'll see what we can do. Or actually, there's nothing more to say now. So even if today's vlog is short, then that's okay. It doesn't bother me. Enough work today has been done, enough of the vlogging has been done, so that I'm happy with what I have. So I'll see you in the next vlog, the next episode. That will probably be tomorrow. I'm planning to go to church in the morning, but we'll see how I feel. I did walk today. I did take you with me today, going to the second store. That's what I forgot I took you with me. So to the second place. And we'll see what happens in the morning. The tea is helping out. I'm drinking the new iced tea that I'm making, the brew myself. It seems to be working. It seems to be giving me more energy, and it's really tasty. I'm kind of addicted to it now. It's a Loganberry date infused tea, so enjoying it very much. Anyways, I'm gonna leave that now. I'll see you tomorrow, possibly in church, and if not, later in the afternoon for lunch or dinner. So take it easy.
Welcome to the library, and I am the librarian.
I am the professor. And professor of what? Professor of physics.
Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light?
Free speech rules here at Democratic Earth.